What is going on, everybody? My name is Mark, and today I want to give you a little update slash rundown of what I've been doing to my A7 for the past couple of months. The last you have heard from me had to be when I did the little overview of what's needed to go stage 2, dual pulleys. Well, since then, I've gotten into a world of mess right now, like I like to call it. But no, I've been installing a widebody kit on my car. And along with the widebody kit, I've been installing the RS7 front bumper. And since my last video, I want to say I did install the Brom racing seats. So before I start off, I want to thank the sponsors that were able to help me out during this build. And those are Clinched Widebody, BK Motorsports, and Brom Racing. So let's jump right into it. So right here, I mean, you can see it's kind of a mess. I'm sorry, I only got like a one car garage anyway. So right here, you can see my RS7 front bumper. What I've ended up doing, like if you followed me on Instagram, you would have known that my kit was already on, riveted on, painted and everything. It just missing the wheels. Well, I didn't like the look of the rivets, needless to say. So what I did was I went ahead and I used this super strong, where is it at? Here it is. Super strong 3M panel bonding adhesive. This stuff is really, really strong. I'm pretty sure I've read it has a tensile strength of 35 to 4,000. So this thing is not gonna come off even if I pull it. But what I did was I basically filled in all the holes with fiberglass body filler and smoothed it down. And then I sanded the rears of it and the body panel itself to bare metal. But I sanded the rear of the flare down so it's flat. And what I did was I basically just tacked on, did a little bead along the side, used self-tapping screws to make sure it laid flat, gave it 24 hours, and it sat on there. Except for this little corner. This little corner kind of messed up when I pulled the front bumper off, but I'm fixing it right now. So give it about tomorrow and it'd be ready to go. But just to give you a good little idea, like, this is overall goal. It's nice and sanded smooth. Probably need a prime down here, but no rivets, no holes, all nicely sanded down and smooth, primed, ready for paint along with this piece. But I know I kind of just skipped over the bumper, what I was doing to it, but yeah, this is the RS7 front bumper. It's a little bit, it's a lot more aggressive, shall I say, compared to the stock one. Basically, what I'm doing here is I'm just the same with all the rest of the kits, making sure all these seams are nice and smooth. One thing I noticed is like the US market A7s, I don't know if the Euro market has them, but we don't have the front washers for the headlights. So what I did was I just basically shaved them down, made them look like they were not even there, along with the front tow hook cover. So it's all one piece, nice and hidden out of the way. All I'm basically doing is I gotta clean up that side and then do the whole bumper and primer, and it's good to go. Moving on to the driver's side here. Just gotta basically, you know, primer, make sure everything's sanded down smooth, ensure that all the edges are lined up nice and neat like, and then it'd be good to go. And I just finished, or not really finished, but still kind of working on this. You can kind of see the process that I'm going at with it. It's like, I'd clean up all the edges, apply Bondo where I need to, and then smooth it out, apply my primer on, and the primer is gonna let me see kind of where all my low and high spots are. So if there's really low spots, I'm just gonna kind of fill it in with more body filler, sand it down smooth, and reprimer it again. Now, the side skirts aren't really on right now. I had an issue with that as for how Clinched really mocked up the design for their wide body kits. The way that they did it was they utilized a premium model A7, which is okay. A lot of the parts fit with the exception of the side skirts. If you have a S7, RS7, or an S-line model, then the side skirts are gonna be completely different. The reason for that being is the S7, RS7, and the S lines, they all have more sportier side skirts. And yes, let me see if I can find, they're over here. So yes, these side skirts would not fit. I've put these side skirts on with my OEM side skirts, and I had an issue with them not sitting properly or anything of that nature. But if you had the base model or the premium with the flat side skirts, it would fit perfect. So what I ended up doing is I just took off the OEM side skirts and gonna figure out a way to bolt this up to the car. That way it's not noticeable, and then get it primed, get it looking good. And then once that's done, the whole car is gonna go off the paint, and really all I need painted is these flares. But overall, it's been a process for someone who's never done a wide body install before. It's definitely a learning experience. I can see why body shops and all that charge a lot. It's definitely a lot of work that goes into it, but the outcome is gonna be worth it, you know? You're gonna be able to turn heads and break necks, as people like to always say, but it's gonna look much more aggressive. Now, if you follow my Instagram, like I said, you'll notice I've been posting pics of my new wheels. So I did get my new wheels. I got them actually in the back of the Q7 here. I'm getting tires for it tomorrow. So reason why I don't have them on right now, or I'm not getting it painted until then, is because, let me see, if you look right here, the little flares have an inner lip to them. And what I want to do is fit tires on my wheels, that way I can air out and make any trimming or adjustments that I needed prior to paint. I don't want to send it to paint and then I end up messing up the paint job. So it's good to always be prepared. But like I said, other than that, that's basically where I'm at. If you're worried about my stage 2 tune, I know some people have been commenting about if I ever installed it. I actually did. I got the Merc Racing heat exchanger right here. It's all installed. All the tubing or coolant hoses are ran nice and cleaned up. I got the ECS supercharger pulley and the ECS crank pulley down there with the provided belt that they gave me. And I'm pushing, I want to say 388 to the wheels and about 450 at the crank. That's what Integrated Engineering says on their site. I never had a chance to get it actually dynoed, so I can't really tell you too much about that. But you definitely feel the difference. That's a thing. It's a big difference in power. I drove all the way from California to Virginia and I had zero issues at all. Along with the roof box, actually was a great investment. I was able to load down all our stuff into the roof box and the seersucker roof mounts. I had zero issues at all with driving across country. With these, I didn't have to adjust them or anything. I mean, they definitely held up. I didn't notice a loss of gas mileage or anything at all, so that was good too. And I mean, they're so convenient, just vacuum suction. So, but while I'm at it, let me show you the new seats. It might be kind of dark in here, I apologize, but these are the new Brom Racing seats that I got. And these are, can't remember what model number they are, but they are the double diamond stitch with this white leather around the edges. And they are reclinable. They do have the sliders. I ended up getting the harness bar. You can kind of see it back there. And I got the 5-point harnesses. I'm only running the 4-point right now until I can figure out where I could put the 5th one. I probably have to bolt it to the bracket itself down there. But overall, I've been riding with them like this since I got the Virginia, and they're really comfortable. They really keep you planted in the seats as well, which is what I really wanted, and definitely worth it. So that's about it, guys. If you have any questions, just leave them down in the comments below. Be sure to hit me up on Instagram if you have any concerns or questions in regards to your A7 build. I've had a couple people hit me up about their builds, asking questions, so keep it up. I'm glad to help out. I love to help out people when I can. But other than that, I'll catch you later and y'all be good.